And the next item on the order paper is a subject for discussion in the name of the Honorable Malema on building state capacity through insourcing of government and all state-owned workers. Honorable Malema.
Thank you very much. Members of the EFF, led by our Deputy President Florence Shivambo, Secretary General Godrich Gadi, let us begin by passing our sincere condolences to the ruling party and the family of Deputy Minister of Mineral Resources, K. Daba Veli Letlongwa, on a tragic passing. It is indeed a loss not only for the ANC, but for the country at large when a young woman leader is lost prematurely on the roads of our country. This is an indication that more work needs to be done in ensuring the safety of our people on our roads so that we can prevent such accidents. May her soul rest in perfect peace. We are here today to forward the struggle for development and building state capacity as enshrined in the 7 cardinal pillars of the EFF. We have witnessed a lack of direction in terms of economic development, and state capacity continues to deteriorate. The private sector in South Africa is now bearing the fruits of its investment in Tumamina, as we are presented with plans to sell the little control over the economy that the state has. Today, we carry the mandate of cleaners and security guards to once again provide a way forward that will benefit the poor masses of our people, develop the state, and save money. From the outset, we must illustrate to the ruling party what a developmental state looks like. A developmental state must drive economic and industrial development independent from capitalists and provide better services to all its people, build and maintain infrastructure, and build an inspired, skilled, and well-compensated workforce. A developmental state must deliver houses, build roads, schools, hospitals, deliver water, and ensure that taxes are spent efficiently. The South African state, in its current form, does not drive the economy or deliver services because it has no capacity. Everything the state does is done through private companies appointed through tenders. Today, government spends an estimated 800 billion through tenders. Today, government appoints private companies to provide simple services such as security, gardening, traveling, cleaning, general maintenance, and other services. Government and state-owned companies appoint companies to build and maintain schools, clinics, hospitals, electricity, power plants, water treatment plants, sanitation plants, and other infrastructure. Government also appoints consultants to develop strategies, write basic documents, reports, and plans. Essentially, what we have is a state that is run like a private company. As South Africa, we have succumbed to the narrative that blacks do not have the capacity to govern their own affairs, that they must be controlled by a private sector, which is dominated by white-owned private companies. A private sector that has no obligation to develop South Africa, but is motivated to bleed us dry of our resources. Inflated prices and corruption are one part of the problem with tenders. The other problem is that these companies make our people work under terrible conditions with long hours, no medical aid, and pay them below living wage. The fate of these workers is suffered by many other workers who have worked as contract workers at PRASA, Transnet, Eskom, DINEL, SAA, and AXA. The question then becomes, what is to be done? As the EFF, we propose that provincial and local government and all state-owned companies must abolish tenders and insource workers on full-time basis. We have led by example with our councillors in municipalities, sponsoring motions of insourcing of cleaners, security guard, gardeners, and general maintenance workers. Due to the intervention and leadership of the EFF, more than 4,000 security guards are insourced in Johannesburg with a salary of 10,000 per month, medical aid, pension, and uniform. More than 1,000 cleaners are employed with a salary of 10,000. Cleaners who used to be employed by private companies are now employed directly by the city of Johannesburg. The EFF caucus in Nelson Mandela Bay, city of Tshwane, and all municipalities that did not have outright winners in 2016 local government elections are engaged in programs that will lead to the insourcing of workers. While there are positive results and correct direction, the only sustainable and long-term solution is national legislation that promotes the insourcing of workers and de-tenderizing the state at all levels. We have since started a process here in Parliament to introduce insourcing private members' bill. A capable state will provide the quality of work and can additionally use its procurement capacity to drive local industrialization and development of the economy. South African government at national, provincial, and all state-owned companies must be rescued from the control of Bidvest Company, which currently is responsible for almost everything that government can do by itself. Bidvest is the biggest culprit in employment of outsourced, underpaid workers as cleaners, gardeners, general workers, and provide a lot of goods and services which the state can purchase with internal capacity. The bill was gazetted in October 2018, and we invite all interested parties to make input so that it can be adopted after the recess and before the end of the year. Let us all unite in saving the money of the taxpayers and put an end to the exploitation of workers by private companies that are in business with the state. Let us unite to build the state capacity and free the ruling party from the chains of Bidvest and Busasa. Building state capacity through the insourcing of workers is one of the many steps towards the economic development. I thank you.
Honorable Machabela, Mashele.
Honorable members.
Honorable Mashele, can you just hold for a while?
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Honorable members. Honorable members. Honorable members, please.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Honorable members, order, please. Honorable members, please. Honorable Kari. Honorable Cardi. Honorable members. Honorable members.
Sorry, House Chair, can you get control of the House, please?
Honorable members, could you please sit down? Honorable members. Honorable members, the behavior is unacceptable, please. Honorable members. Order, honorable members. Honorable members, please. Can we bring the House to order? Honorable members, let us not allow ourselves to deteriorate the decorum of the House. We are all responsible for it. We cannot go on like this. We are all responsible. We are all responsible. We are all responsible members of this House. I repeat. And we take charge of the decorum of the House, each one of us. We cannot go on like this. Honorable Mashele, can you take the podium?
Sorry, House Chair.
Honorable Member, why are you rising?
House Chair, sorry, I'd like to take a point of order.
What's your point of order?
The point of order, House Chair, is that I would be expected of the presiding officer to at least request an investigation into the circumstances that have just happened. You say we're all responsible for decorum in the House. You're responsible for upholding the rules of Parliament. What has just happened here is a gross violation of the rules of Parliament. And I would really request you as a presiding officer to at least initiate an inquiry into what has just happened here. It's not acceptable for members to be threatened in the way that they've been threatened.
Order, honourable members. I have taken concern of that, honourable member. I'm aware of that. We'll make a follow-up on that. Order, yes, honourable members.
I don't
honourable
know.
Honourable member, why are you rising?
I don't know what must be investigated because people were talking to each other here. Do we investigating people talking to each other honourable, these days?
Honourable member.
For real, honourable Chief Whip of the DA, people were talking to each other. I saw the president of the EFF speak to another member until they finished. Now we must investigate even what you just said there to each other. What's going to happen? Investigate the conversations of people honourable all over the House.
Thank you very much.
Let's debate insourcing, please.
Honourable Ndlozi, of course, we'll go to answer, check what has happened, and take appropriate measures. Thank you very much.